You are awesome in this place, mighty God. You are awesome in this place, Abba Father. You are worthy of all praise. In you our lives will end. You are awesome in this place, mighty God.
You are worthy of all praise.
In you
my God, my creator. My God was always there. The Lord was seated high above in his throne. The Lord that never changed. The Lord that stays on the promises of his word. The Lord that never lies. The Lord that is always there for me. I just love to praise you today. I just love to worship you today. I love to give you all the praise and glory that is supposed to be due unto you. For you are God, you are the creator. For you are God, you do not change. You are God, you are not a liar, you're like men. Father, whatever you say cometh to pass. Whatever you start, Heavenly Father, will come to an end. Whatever, Heavenly Father, you say you shall accomplish, it happens. That is why I glorify your name always. That is why I bow before you always, Lord, to give you praise. Oh God, I worship you. Oh God, I bless your mighty holy name. What a God I serve. What a God I worship. Maria Labosia Terebeshika. You are a faithful God. You are a righteous Lord. You are the I am that I am. You are the Lord that is always there. Seated high above the throne. My God who is worthy to be worshipped. My God who is to be praised. My God who is to be worshipped as all. That Heavenly Father belong unto you. Papa ndiya maribu ndiya barosha. Yova ndiya bakota ndiya bahulisa. Kaba siite na musi Yesu. Kaba siite na musi Yehova. Kaba tomenga ne mwena ndishanduke. Kaba tomenga ne Yehova vangite. Nifadere bukara litatulu. Sweet Jesus. Sweet Jesus. What a wonder you are. You are brighter than the morning star. For you are fairer, Jehovah, much fairer than the lily that grows by the wayside. You are precious, Papa, most precious than gold. Sweet, sweet, sweet
Jesus.
Sweet, oh Jesus.
You
Can you clap your hands? Jump up like a crazy person. Shout and scream. Glorify his name. Bless his mighty name. Worship him. Let the worship are due to him. They are due to him for his wealthy. They are due to him for his awesome. They are due to him for his great. What a great God we serve. What an awesome God we serve. Glory be unto God in the highest. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can you shake the person that is close to you? Are you happy? Are you here or are you absent? If you are absent, you are in trouble. Avail yourself now, because you will lose a lot if you don't avail yourself. You can be here by flesh with your body and your head and your feet and your shoes and your clothes, but you are not here. Some of us right now, we are busy in our kitchen preparing lunch. Some were thinking, what is it that we are going to do tomorrow? We are not here. Can you shake the person that is close to you? Are you here?
Are you here?
Now I'm here by fire, by force.
I'm here by fire
and anointing. There is nothing you can do about it. Hallelujah. Yeah. Clap your hands and thank the Lord. Oh, Jesus, I love you so much. Pezu Gwenta, Panzi Kwamafu, Ebu Kosini, Hagari Bege, Cecilia Intile, Sitana Zela, Infusele. Hello. I give you the praise. Oh, God is good, though. You know, I remember a song that we once sung many years ago. It says, when I remember what the Lord has done, I will never, even if you say something, I will never. Even if you insult me, forget it, I will never. Even if you speak about me, forget it, I will never. Unkulunkulu mayengisindisa webe na ube ukuphi. Glory to the name of the Lord. Yeah! 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 You don't know salvation, Elena. You know, yesterday I was thinking. And when I was thinking, I said, Mara Chirizi, you know, I don't know what I'm saying. You know, I'm going to go to the groove. Eh? I'm going to go to the rock. I guess I would like to live a little bit of a little Malawi, Zambia, Zimbabwe, or USA. Marok Salayon, Nikitabaki Rokano. You know, now, this is the something that troubles me so much. When we come into the house of Lord, we totally forget. Hankabe Jesu, Asam Pulusha, Nikitabaki Likai. Do you ever think about this? That's why always I will say, tell your friend that is close to you, from now on I don't know you. I'm here all by myself. Whatever that is going to happen here today, it's me and Papa God alone. I don't want you to intermingle with my affairs with my father. Why? Because the day he saved me, you were not there. And the things that were happening to me, you don't have even a tip of an iceberg, an idea of what was happening in me. I am the only person who knows where I come from. I am the only person who knows the grace that has appeared unto me. Titus said, for the grace of God that bringeth salvation has appeared to all men. But when this grace appeared, can you tell the person that is close to you, when this grace appears? Baba, this grace is totally knocked down beyond repair, written off in life. How feet are rest in peace before you are even buried. But when the grace of God finds you, you don't know what I'm talking about. You don't know what I'm trying to explain. When that grace takes you. I love the word of the Lord because he says, he calls you by your name. Let's say, what are you, Tola? Chirizi? Come here. Kashalamra. Orikia kaina kita no shalamra bare ke phuloshe ona ke no phulo today ona wa ke lapile batho ba morena ere ke no yana ko we ke phamisa matso mothomo o taluka. And now when you become born again, when you become saved, you start experiencing the warmth of salvation. Uyazi noma bakulahlile noma bangakunaki noma bangakuboni, you know, when you are born again, that first day when you start to move out, your footsteps matters. Maunyathela unyathela ngesizotha phela mina ngumzulu mani ngiyazi amaunyathela unyathela ngesizotha hezwi bathikanda phasi zwiyapfala uri Mrs. Makarani Sofira uyafuna ufune utshotshori ulibelele uri ke manga fitile because of the grace. Now this day sithi nabazalwane, we have forgotten all about grace. Oh God, help us as your church. Forgotten all about grace. It is not because you are special. Astaba ya urubelelwe ke mang mang. It's because of the grace. You are here because of the grace. So now can you take care of what the grace has presented unto you? Ere ke le botseng taba ye nngwe e special a ka nna a bana ke ya kerekeng ga ke tsoa o seng ke rapela ke re papa setaela se la se fithile gabedi ke re wena papa wa tsebo rena ke setaela anongthuse today ke opela go opela o nkokeletse boaswi ka gore lerato le is too much mo go nna. Ke nya gore le bana ba ba bone lerato le o re ratileng ka lona ka gobane nna I've already experienced the depth of the love of God. When God says he will save you, when he saves you indeed. When he heals you in perfection. Huh? When he says I'm doing this to you, he does it completely in perfection. I was an entrepreneur in your gang, who petty low fedite, kitu, ntosonjo, idire. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Are we here today? Are we present? Can you ask the person that is close to you, are you present? SJ Isu. Oh, SJ Aviesa. Yeah, it's me, Isoni. I guess Isu. And I fear that the era shall may seal Fandah. Elena, let's say, get some less of a woman. I'll be out the lamar and go Veladia Honal. Elena, let's say, are we all happy? But some like a little so car, give one of our own car as a market fella. I am about to come with him. To take let's say, let's say, like a Morauka calendar, Casillabas. Our syllabus have a pillow in fitting like in a global chamang. Syllabus a hal in Chile. I guess I want to lose war. You know, in Chabella Lake is all say. You know, to a babble. So, Carolina Lita Chile, I get the worry, Rowling, get up with Talus. Maraco, now no tea. I go with him to link for a quoted in Titania, Mona. Wona le ngwe she ba e bolela ba re ke spring ba re ke a ke re ana bia le ke spring anger winter o tsamae ya no nkina ko ya o ya o tivi ya kaya ma jasi fasi a na ke no ba ke a pre jasi ka hore ke tshela mafelelo anger ma jasi fasi o iphuthe botse o ibu ya kanye o bona a lo re ngwana modimo a pholushitseng ya yang le godimo. Hallelujah. Are we happy? Can you ask your friend, are you happy? We are in the house of God. Our burdens are going to be taken away. Our burdens are going to be eroded away by the love and the blessings from the Lord God Almighty. If you believe it, can you clap your hands? Hallelujah. Disatibi murena Disatibi chirizi Dobandi swibini Dobandi chikani Disatibi murena Disatibi chirizi Petsi lingwe tuba Natangana na Yesu Lingwe tuba Natangana na muchizi Lingwe tuba Natangana na muramuruli Lingwe tuba Natangana na mubufuruli Nde lingwe tuba Natangana na Yesu Lingwe tuba Natangana na muchizi Nde lingwe tuba Natangana na muramuruli Lingwe tuba Natangana na mubufuruli Lingwe tuba Natangana na Yesu Ndendo tangana na Yesu uchira shanduka 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 Ndendo tangana na Yesu uchira shanduka
Já está na saco, já está na saco. I'd like to thank God. He has blessed me with a baby boy. After I came for the week of grace in February, he delivered me from the spirit that didn't want me to deliver. I thank God for that.
Amen.
Amen.
I greet you in the name of Jesus.
Do me di shoka libiso la Jesu.
Me last month I was here in July.
Veke au fita ka mkhwedi cha au fita ka July veke le mo.
I was HIV positive.
Veke le HIV positive.
But that time I was came here, I was scared for the people to come here and to talk about my HIV positive.
Bekichaba matlo ba thu ke chaba lore batho ba ka bolela ka bolwetse bo ke na leng bone.
But that time I opened my heart, I deliver in the name of Jesus.
Kana ko ila ka bula pelo ya ka modimo ba ntokolla ka lebitso la Jesu.
And the mommy pray for me.
Le mama ba ntapelela.
And I go home.
Ka ya boela gae.
I'm staying in Cape Town.
Kidula Cape Town.
But I was thinking, what can I do? Because the God gave me the life from that time I was HIV until here.
Kai putshoreng ka dira eng ka re modumba mphile bophelo go tlwana ko ela ke lwala go fitlhagane jwale.
But I'm saying thank you God, because me I can't even walk.
Ke lebo modimo ka re be ke sa kgone lo sepela.
My foot was so painful and hot. I was taking the water in the bucket and put my feet inside.
Mautwa ka ba rurile e bile a fisha a le botoko. Be ke tsiya pakete ya metsi ka tsentsha ka gare mauto.
I can't even eat.
Be ke sa kgone loja.
I can't even work.
Be ke sa kgone lo bereka.
I stay long time and the people say I must take the money to send home for me, but I say I can't go because I'm gonna suffer a lot.
Be ke lo ala ebile ke tla share batho ba ba mpha maela gore o kaone ke gae ka hana ka gore be ke tse gore ke tlo sokola le go feta.
But now I'm working.
Anijwale ke a bereka.
And the boss is taking me through in aeroplane to come here.
Mo thoke mmerekang o nna meditse aeroplane gore ke fitlhe mo.
But I'm saying thank God, because me, he gave me the step. And I don't have anything like money, because the money I was, that time I was sick. I can't even do anything. But the people helped me to borrow the money. So now that I'm working, I take the money to send for the people. I'm saying thank you, because the people, he take me the life, and the God, he take me the life until here. So I'm saying thank you God, because there's some of people, you are there, you're hiding about your sickness, but you can't heal.
Ke leboa modimo ka gore nna ba nkgontshe le hebe ke sina tšhelete ya go tla mo modimo ba ile ba kgone gore ke khumane batho ba ka nthušang ka tšhelete ore ke kgone go patela ke tle mo ka morago mo modimo ga nejo le ba ntšhofetse ka mmereko ke kgone go patela dikoloto tša ka ga nejo le ke fodile ke kgona le go phela ga botse nka eletsa ba bangwe. Ba ne ba tshwana le nna motlhongwe ba dutse fase ba na le bolwetse a ba tse gore ba ka reng ka bone.
And when I have nice phone, that thing you can say, you can believe, because I can take the picture that I was. I have the face, he was big, come big. And I said, thank God, because now even the people, when you look at me, you scared. I say, why the God is can heal the people? Now he believes the people.
Kileboa modimo ka gore be ke rurile le mmele ka moka le sefatlheo ane jwale ke fodile le batho ba mmaka le gore modimo mphodišitše.
But I'm saying thank you God, because when you are opening your heart, you come from, you come this place, everything is possible for every people.
Kileboa modimo,
no matter you don't have anything, but when you take the step to come this place, everything is possible. Me, I'm not like that. But when I'm there at home, I'm going to suffer a lot. But I'm saying, I believe that Jesus, that's why now you see me like that.
Kelebwa modimo ka hore ha o fitla mo o bolapelo ya gago ka mokhadi ya khonagala ha o dumela modimo ba go ntsha kelebwa modimo ka hore ke fodile. Amen.
Greetings in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I'm just standing here to thank the Lord for what he has done for my family.
He
has blessed us with a Hyundai accent.
Accent. Amen. Greetings in the name of Jesus.
For week of grace.
On June, I brought two of my children for the week of grace.
The other one, Nashim studied drugs at Subadipache.
The other one was addicted to drugs and marijuana.
After deliverance, I robbed 3 days. I'm phone la mama ke akwa.
After he got delivered, we went home and he slept for 3 days, which he called me after that and he said, "Mommy, I'm dying."
And ne akhata dilo tse a sa di bone spiritually.
He said he was vomiting things that he couldn't see with his own eyes.
Now he's delivered. Is free. Asa di berekisa in Jesus' name.
Right now, my son is delivered. He's no more taking drugs and marijuana. He's released in Jesus' name.
Hapo botlele se se a o mo tsa na university.
His sister, who's attending in university, was also here.
Apostle Mudija are lesa dilo tse ka mokatse tse di fake, marato a di fake alfase o shumele modimo.
Daddy told her to leave everything and the love of the world, which is fake, and she should serve God.
We were waiting, we really emeti bazari ke January. After the deliverance, bazari yatla honubia aleka July.
We were waiting for the bazari that we applied in January. Daddy didn't come, but after deliverance in July, the bazari came through.
And then anyaka dispects, I won't have a problem ya macho.
She also has problem with her eyes.
So ne anyaka di prelegs na chelete.
She was looking for spectacles and I didn't have money.
So ka university ba mmotsa gore ba nyaka o dire practical ka yena ba mfa di specs ba mfa di lens mahala.
So in the school they said they want to do practicals, they will use her as a sample and they provided everything for her.
I thank God because kitlemo charisi ke sna mereko ke lose ntlo ke lose koloi ke lose marriage, you lose everything. The chelete,
I thank God because when I came to Charis, I had lost my job, my house, my car, my marriage, my finances. I had lost everything in life.
After Daddy prayed for me, I got a job and I bought a car also.
After Daddy prayed for me, kileka kumana meroko kava kareka lekoloi.
The name of the car is Yaris 2017 model.
It's a Yaris 2017 model. Amen. Greetings in the name of Jesus. My testimony is about the prayer that I was praying with Daddy.
On YouTube.
On the YouTube. He was saying that we should pray for our bank accounts. We should take out our bank cards.
And then you ask
you the I didn't know that there was a company which owes me money. I found that they have deposited my money in the bank.
And then school fees.
I was also supposed to pay the school fees for my child. When I got to the bank, I found that the ATM says I should take out the money before I can insert my card.
And then in the statement,
I read the statement and took the money.
And then she baranda wa nauchela denda bandu koi to doru ndio badelela wana school fees.
When I counted it, I found it is exactly the amount that I needed to pay for my son's fees.
And then ya ubirindia musindi ko ngwala mulingo mshumoni.
The second testimony is when I was writing my exam at work.
Roba rona angwari batan.
We were five who were chosen.
And then esnani roya chikoloni afirikoti ngwala mulingo.
When we went to school, they told us they would take us to exams.
And then mulingo otoma nda ufeira.
The first one, I failed it.
Wa ubiri na wana nda dufera nga makzenda bandozi wana 75%, derikoti opasanga 80%.
The second one I also failed because they wanted 80% and I got 75%.
And then does realize our zukambore opportunity to compare.
I realized that it means this opportunity will pass me by.
And I ringasimpira una mamina dead in duni.
I said to myself, they won't pass me when I have mami and dead in the house.
Ndazukanduni nda ambara shikipa chenda chirenga cha mamina dead.
I got at home, I wore my cherished t-shirt.
Ndarabela nechila chikipa nda pointana ka calendar na anointing water.
I prayed wearing the t-shirt and I also wrote on the calendar with the anointing water.
And then in that spray akabukuzenda banduko zibananda zibuzori zote zine zwa contrast uri ndivena stagnant cha percent zivete oni yanga ndikono fesise yo buku.
I sprayed the book and I was praying and saying whatever that is stopping me from catching everything and making me to be stagnant, they should leave me.
And then ndori ndichipedza unushera kamadi noambara shikipa na this prayer muviri wothe ndachimuwanga mara.
After I had prayed and sprayed my body with my books with the anointing water, I had running stomach.
And then the following day ndichongwana ndotwa ndoambara shikipa.
The following day when I went to write my exam, I was wearing the t-shirt.
Ndadwanda this prayer.
I also sprayed myself again.
And then ndapasa nga 91%.
I passed with 91%.
Ndikodivwa mzimu.
I thank God. Amen.
I greet you all in the wonderful name of Jesus.
Madumeka lebitso la Jesu.
Ndikonya gorivwa mudzimu nga zve varitera zvone.
I like to thank God for what he has done for me.
Mudzimu vo bless akara dzianga nga guru.
God has blessed my brother with a car.
Charity ego.
It's a charity ego. It's a cherry ego.
Greetings in the mighty name of Jesus.
Madumeka lebitso la Jesu.
I'm standing here to thank the Lord for what he has done for me.
Keme mole wa mudimo ka 70 teaching son.
I had a privilege to attend one on one. That was, I think it was on Friday the 18th, 18 August 2017.
Ke le ka bala monyetla wa go tikhumana ke gone go tsenela one on one ya di 18 August ngwa go.
And then I was prophesied by Prophet Emmanuel.
Nekile ka prophesy wa ka mwa ba prophet ba mo kerekeng.
And then he asked me, ma'am, I see you on a managerial position.
Bar monna ba mpona ke me mo boemo ba bo manager.
And then I explained to him that I perform the functions, duties of managerial position only on acting capacity.
Kamo chakare ki mo boemong ke berekela boemo bo ba bo manager ke simo bona boemong bo.
But then he kept on saying, but I see you on a managerial position.
Bachola pele ba re ko bona o le mo boemong bo.
Then he said, I'm giving you 1 month.
Bar monna ba mpha kgwedi ete.
And then he keep quiet.
Ba khomola.
So on the 18th of September, which was last week,
ka di 18th of September e be le ke o feta,
I left work I think in the afternoon because I was not feeling well.
Ke le ka tloga mmereko montsha re ka re bekisa te kwe botse.
And then the following day on the 19th when I arrived, and then my manager called me and asked to see me.
Ake fitla mmereko tshela tamba manager wa ka ampicha aronya kompone.
And then to my surprise he handed over the letter for promotion on a managerial position.
Ake fitla bamphale ngwalo la hore ke tlatshitswe ke promote lo ke lo ba manager.
I just want to thank the Lord for what he has done for me.
Ke rato le bo modimo se ba mteaching son.
Amen.
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 And go tamo ribuwa mzimu ngazwa nyetera zone.
I'd like to thank God for what he has done for me.
Ngamsumburu ndova ndiko shuma night shift.
On Monday I was working on night shift.
Oringa about 11, other the armed robbers.
Around 11 o'clock, armed robbers came in.
Ba rijera zi phone.
They took our phones.
Marandikoribu achirizi chamzimu ngore auna namti wea ubara.
I thank the grace of God because nobody was injured.
Enengailo duvandoro ndichiba rumunu nenda zura unenda bandora bera.
On that day when I left my place, I prayed.
Atimutu osoko rabera marandobandora bera for protection.
That day I had prayed for protection.
Danwana anointing water.
I also drank the anointing water.
Ngoribu amzimu ngazwezu.
I thank God for that. Amen.
Namshawata ebitro yeso.
Greetings in the name of Jesus.
Minanranda ukeso shkwembu kubashi nyikilentiro.
I'd like to thank God for blessing me with a job.
Tolo ni receive a call.
Yesterday I received a call. They said I should come for an interview on Wednesday the 27th.
Ukeso shkwembu yeso.
I thank God for that.
Greetings in the name of Jesus.
My dear, make a little bit of Jesus.
I attended the night of shifting last week Friday.
We killed more for night of shifting. Beke of itagalavtan.
And I was given a prophecy.
Kileka kumana si profeto.
And this Tuesday, I was blessed with a permanent job.
Kalabu vidika kumana mushomo. Amen.
Greetings all in the name of Jesus.
My dear, make a little bit of Jesus.
I'd like to thank God for what He did for me.
Keratole wa mudim seven teaching son.
Earlier this year, he blessed me with a company.
Mwawa utoma mudiban chufajika company.
The name of the company is House of Tukela Holdings.
It's a House of Tukela Holdings.
And this year, I'm doing it as a part time for this company.
Sorry?
This company, I'm doing the part time.
I'm running the company part time.
And this year also, this month he helped me also with a new job.
Mudimba chufajika mushumo moswa kodiye.
I just like to thank God for that.
Kelewa mujumka se. Amen.
Greetings in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Tumedisho kalebisola Jesu.
I'm here to thank God and exalt His wonderful name for what He has done for me and my family.
Kimoyo upamisha mujumu lo balebwa sebatiching laping lak.
God is awesome, bazalwane. He has blessed me with a permit. I glorify God.
Modimba shufajeka permiti. The permit for?
A permit for work, for business.
Modimba shufajeka permiti ya obereka. Di papiri chao di tukelo or kihono obereka.
I just glorify God. He's awesome. The anointing at this place is powerful, bazalwane. It just took a week to get this permit.
Kilewa modimka orichere veke fela or kikumane permiti.
Amen.
Amen.
I greet you all in the mighty name of our Savior.
Tumedishokale bitsola Jesu.
I would like to thank God for blessing me with a car.
Kiratolo ba mutumba shufa chika koloi.
Name of the car is Polo 1.4 red metallic.
It's a Polo what?
1.4.
It's a Polo 1.4. Amen. I greet you all in the name of Jesus.
I lost my son
and my husband 2 years ago. I have 2 weeks coming to the church. On Friday, I was supposed to have gone home. Then my child said, "Mommy, don't go home. I want you to take me to the church you are coming from." My child was born in 93 and the child is unable to stay at home. She would cook and she'll go and stay next door. She'll come back just to finish up cooking. After she turned the pots, she will close them up and go back next door. She said to me, please don't take me, don't go home. I want you to take me to the church you are coming from. Indeed, I didn't go home. After she told me that she left on Friday, that she came back yesterday, and when she came back, she said, Mommy, please, I thank you, you didn't go home. Please take me to the church tomorrow so that your life and our lives would be safe. She then said to me, I was supposed to kill you and my sibling. She left and she never came back. Around 10, I said to the younger child, let us go to church. Without her coming back. I thank God for saving my life, because if I didn't come to this place, I wouldn't know the intention behind my daughter. I thank God for that.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Last week Sunday on my way back home, I had an accident here at N1. I would like to thank Jesus for saving my life. I came out of the car without any physical injury. Amen.
Amen.
Greeting to you all in the name of Jesus. I would like to thank God for what He has done in my life. Firstly,
Samatomo,
they were trying to steal my books at school, but they have failed.
Bapaleji.
Secondly,
Sabobedi,
at school,
Koskolong.
Every year in June, everyone was dying. But this year, they have failed to kill us. Thirdly, I'd like to thank God that He has released my menstruation. I'd like to give advice to you all. God cannot create a key with cannot create a lock without a key. And He cannot give you a situation without a solution. Thank you.
Greetings in the name of Jesus. I'd like to thank God for what He has done for me. One day I was here as a visitor for one-on-one.
I was looking for a job. And man of God told me, are otobereka.
And the man of God told me that you will work.
And I got a job of my studies.
Kikhumane moshomo ku yeching skolong. I thank God for that. Amen. Greetings in the name of Jesus. I'm standing here to thank God
for what He has done for us.
Sebaradirejing sona. God has blessed us with a car.
Tuscan 2017 model.
It's a Tuscan 2017 model. Amen.
Open the floodgates in abundance and cause your rain to fall on me. Allow the Spirit of the Lord to minister to you. Open the floodgates in abundance and cause your rain fall me. Open the floodgates. In abundance.
In abundance.
And cause your race.
Cause your race.
Can you raise your hands to the Lord?
Thank you, Jesus. I cry, Baba.
Praise the Lord. In Jesus' name. I was learning why devil tried to attack people. And then how he attacks people. I want to talk about it today.
Tutauri why Satan attacks watu. Lord, oba attacka kama khwama.
And then already we have learned last time that the best weapon is opposition inside.
Ke setere ithutile ro hanetjo ha o lenka ha re ke sona sishumishwa sisikaone sa Satan.
There was a time where you know God showed me that unless the opposition is inside
here,
you won't be affected by that opposition. And then we need to know that Satan will never attack where your strength
Satan
is not there.
So where our attack is more than the
devil always look at your strength.
Satan would develop
matter. Your strength is found. It's out of your strength that God will take you far.
So
what devil does, he makes sure that he monitor you.
Satan
and check your strength. That is why the Bible says Satan is roaring like a
lion. That's why Satan
around you. Try to check if you will fear. Where you don't fear, that's where he attacks. I don't know if you're hearing that. So the best weapon is betrayal.
So because
you cannot betray unless you are close to the person. I don't know if you're hearing me. Me and Mama, we have faced a lot of betrayers. Some people, you know, you take them close like this. And then from there, they just blow your mind. You know, you see taking people close here. It's very, very dangerous. Very, very dangerous. Taking people here. You know, it's very, very dangerous. And then when you are living on earth, you cannot say you want to live alone. You still need people. But make sure that your strength is not in them. If your strength is in the Lord, when they destroy you here and betray you, you are still going to stand and move forward. I don't know if you are hearing that. So this week I've been hearing issues of strength.
So
that you need to accomplish your destiny. You need strength so that you reach where God wants you to
be.
It's not your ability to do things.
It's
how far you endure. You know, everybody can still do whatever. But how far you are beaten,
mara wena o hanelwe ha ka kang wa bitwa ka
ka o kopana le jo
go bona le tsona ka kang o fetela go no fita mafelong ke yona ntwe botlhokwa yeo.
I don't know if you're hearing me.
Na ke tse borile ntona.
It's not issue of, you know, you can be achieving this.
Astaba yo
everybody can achieve that.
Wa gona gwetsa tse wa gwetsa tse le tsela motho ka o fela ga idea yeo.
But that you cannot achieve. Mara na le ntwe o ka se
gona o di gwetsa modimo fa ka o thompa.
It means you to have strength in the Lord.
Di ya gore wena o be o tile mo rene.
Your strength must be drawn from the Lord.
Mata ha wa tsontsho ba itjwa mo rene.
Drawn from the Lord.
A itjwa mo rene.
I don't know if you're hearing that.
Ke tse ba le ntwe.
As you never say my friend.
Mo tsha motho leng ka from khotse.
Where lies your strength?
Mata ha wa robetse kae?
That's where Satan is attacking.
Ke mo Satanga tanga khotha khotantsi.
I don't know if you're hearing that.
Ke tseba lentwa.
So I'm preaching this today.
Ke bolela ka taba ye le khono ka hore.
I think I have learned out of my experience.
Ke nana re ke tshile ka laba kala tshe ke kopana le tsona ka jolo ka muruti.
I've also learned, some of you saw that I've learned, you know, to endure and keep quiet.
Lo khotelela le o khomola.
You know, there are some things that when they are coming to hit your face,
bona le dilo chetengwa di tsho tlo o betha patai,
you realize that everybody knows that scar.
O ta tsebo re batho ka o fela ba to tseba le swao leo.
But it takes the grace of God.
Mara wonya ka ala fela gaogelo ya
tate. I believe that God gives you
le bo o ne bo modema o feeling bona ka hare.
To move out and move forward with the same scar.
O tla o ya pele bona le lebadi lona lela.
You know, a scar is remembrance.
Lebadi ku di re gone go pola.
When people look at you, they remember.
Ha ba thuba o lebella ba go pola.
But you find that you still remember, but we are moving.
Mara batholoro o ya go pola mara o ntse o tswela pele.
I don't know if you're hearing me.
Anke tse ba le ntwa.
Can you see people who are close?
Wa bona ba ba leng gaufinya na bana ba
o
yekile. Ha o se jwalo.
You're not going anywhere.
A ora ora o mo ya ngona.
Tell me, can you see people who are close?
Wa bona bana ba ba leng gaufinya na bana ba o yeka.
If they are not doing that,
ha ba so to me.
It means there's no assignment in your life.
Ora ora ha ona buyo ina ona mushumo ka
wena. Your assignment.
Mushumo wa hao
is determined by how far you can take
when now o gono tshia tshekakang.
What is coming from your opposition?
Ke di tshang ba ba lwanang le wena ba wanganetse.
When we read Luke 22,
a le ka bala mola go Luke 22
from 42.
Luke 22 from 42.
We once spoke about this. Luke 22 from 42 to 44.
From 42 to 44.
Are you there?
Literacy.
Look what?
22.
From 42.
Otwa verse 42.
Yes. There.
Alamola.
Jesus prayed this prayer. Father, if thou be willing, remove this cup from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but thine be done. 43. Amen. And there appear unto him an angel from heaven, strengthening him. Being in an agony, he prayed more earnestly.
Amen.
And his sweat became as it were great drops of blood falling down upon the ground. Let's Amen. Pray. Thank you, Lord, for your word in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
If you can read here, you can see
how kabala moto le mora.
The sweat like blood.
Ore kodumela ya swana le marotho dia mati.
He never sweat the blood.
Azanga a tshekudumela mati. Na a tswa kudumela.
Because he was in agony.
Ka o bane na kwa botlhoko.
Listen to this. One of the things that I've read about Jesus.
Ntshomwe na ke ithuteleng yona ke ibala ka Jesu.
I didn't even understand why he called Judas friend.
Why na a bitsa Judas ore ke mogwera.
Because the first time when he saw Judas, he said, "There comes my friend." But I understood it later that the reason why he called him friend was he was helping Jesus accomplish his destiny. Though Jesus was supposed to go through that, he knew that this man, something can happen out of him.
Na tse bo re monna o ka ta o ja tshwelela se sengwe mo go yena.
You see, when you are working with somebody, you just know.
Wa bana ntse se o tsamaya le motho, o tsamaya le motho.
You just know that by something is like it will happen.
O no kwishisha lo thalwanyo re se sengwe se ka no diragala.
But when it happened,
mara jono ha se diragala seo.
Jesus was in agony.
It
was only one thing that he can pray.
Lord, this is the cup
that you want me to drink.
Or
allow it to pass. But let it be your will. You know, if you reach a level where you say, as long as it is your will,
as long as I can buy it,
no longer your own will. Can you say your will is whatever you ask, whatever you think, whatever you ask, whatever you think, is your will. But think about now God's will. When you reach a point where you say, Lord, I'm suffering, but if it is your will. In other words, you are accepting everything, though it was not your way. When I read that, the Bible says heaven was watching, same time the angel was sending to Jesus to come and strengthen
him.
If Jesus was not strengthened, his prayer will be a complaint. You can understand, say, you see now, if it is your way, I mean, he was supposed to be saying, can you see, I'm suffering. Look how I will die. I have never done wrong. But why must I go to the cross? Despite that, this is sin. When Jesus was saying that, now heaven said, no. Whatever he speaks, it happened. The plan can be changed. Let's strengthen him to face the same plan, so that
he'll
be able to accomplish what he was there for. I'm here to tell you that unless God strengthen you, you won't achieve things that God wants you to achieve. People can still praise you outside, but inside God knows that this is not the plan he was having with your life. I don't know if you are hearing me. You need God to strengthen you. Tell your neighbor, say, my friend, you need God to strengthen you. You need the strength of God. I don't know if you are hearing me. So when Jesus was praying, the Bible says, after the strength, he prayed earnestly more. Though he was in agony, but his prayer was not changed
in
agony. You know, when you're in agony, you can
affect it,
and you present things in a wrong way. You pray in pain or in complaints. But Jesus was on the same level. His prayer was so powerful when he was facing the cross, through the person he knew. You know, there was something that I was meditating. I felt, I've been telling Mama this thing.
And
I said, if we can check how we suffer with people, this teaches us not to trust anybody. Mama was saying to me, how can you live without trusting
them?
And I said, trusting and living is a different thing. You can love people but don't trust them. Because the moment you trust them, you give them your heart. One of the temptations that Jesus faced, because Lazarus, by the time when he died, when he rose, when people were looking around, they wanted to kill him and kill Lazarus. That one triggered the cross. And Judas was there. He was seeing. Judas was also a person who was seeing that great miracle.
Judas
could see that this man can raise people from the dead. But still the same person who saw miracles, who saw resurrection, came and betrayed. I don't know if you're hearing me. So this man had broken his
heart. gage.
I'm sure you understand what I'm talking about.
Ke dumela le ka ba.
And another thing is,
tsana ntwa ye ngwa shi gape.
Show that Judas was trusted.
O bontsha re Judas na botiwa.
The whole money of the ministry was in his hands.
Tsela ya mushumo wa Jesu, ya mushumo wa mudimo wa Jesu. Ne o le matsonga ai.
I don't know if you're hearing that.
A ke tsheba le ntwa.
Just somebody say, hey, I love you.
Botsha motho leng ka fore ke o rata jwa ngwana.
But I can't trust you.
Ah, mara o tshepa wona ke tapale.
Why? Because
why le ba ka la wona sele?
There is a journey.
Wona le lieto.
I need the strength.
Ke thoka mata.
After I've been affected by you.
Ke affectiwe ka wena.
I need the strength.
Ke thoka mata.
After I've been broken by you.
Ka mara hore ke robiwe ke wena.
I need strength.
Ke thoka mata.
After I've been blocked by you.
Ka mara hore ke tswalelwe ke wena.
So that I carry on.
Hore ke khono tswela pele ke sitele mo la mushumo wa
God has placed me to affect some people positively.
That
negatively.
O fetisha hore ke ba affect ka tsela
efe. I don't know if you're hearing that.
Na ke tsebo le ntona.
Check somebody say, my friend.
O shishinyo lo nka from
God. Interested you with your destiny. How many of you are hearing that? How many of you are hearing that? You can still carry on because the strength is not outside of you. It's inside you. You can pray and see no results, but you carry on because the strength is inside you. It's not outside you. Some people can look at you and say, if God is with you, you were supposed to have done 1, 2, 3, but you find that you are not looking on those things because the strength is inside you. It's not around you. Check somebody say, my friend, I have the strength to move forward. Hallelujah.
Praise Jesus.
In 2 Timothy 4,
verse 14 to 18.
Timothy was warned by his father.
Timothy, we love
that he needs God to strengthen him. Because he will meet opposition. Listen to this. Timothy was a son of Paul.
Timothy nalimurwa wa Saul, wa Paul.
But if you read there, you realize that he had all things from young age. And he was born in the family of the people who fear God. I'm sure you're hearing that. I mean, all those parents, even the grandmother, fear God. But when he met Paul, Paul always never talk about where he come from. He talk about his destiny. I mean, the grandparents could talk about, we know you. We follow God. Even you can follow God. But when Paul spoke with Timothy, he said, you must allow God to strengthen you. If God strengthen you, it's for his own approval of the assignment he gave you. I don't know if you are hearing that. If you read there, you will see that it was like a warning that he was given. That you will face opposition. Opposition is nice if you have been warned. Tell him, opposition is very good if you have been warned. I don't know if you're hearing that. You see, when people warn you, especially spiritual people, they are trying to say, don't lose what you have received. Sometimes we don't want to be warned. We end up losing what God has entrusted us with. There are some people here, God has entrusted you with big things. Big things. Things that everybody will end up knowing. Don't lose what God has given you. I'm warning you. I say there's opposition you don't know. You know, when you are sitting very close to someone, you might be sitting very close to someone who has been settled by Satan. Maybe when you check your friends, sometimes you must know them. Who are the real friends or their friends? It's true, you won't live alone. But it's possible that the right one, the one one you trust is the one that devil wants to take from you and use it against you. I don't know if you're hearing me. Trust me, my friend. Opposition is there, but you're not aware of it. I don't know if you're hearing me. Listen, if opposition, you are aware of it, you are a winner already. If you are aware of your opposition, you are a winner. In my language,
the snake that you have seen before can never bite you.
But the hidden one,
the snake that is hidden,
can really destroy you. I don't know if you're hearing me. Listen, you need to know your assignment. And you need to know why you are facing all this. Don't call anything blessing if it's not coming in the right way. It might be coming to trap you or to destroy you. Don't call anything you don't understand. Anything. I don't know if you're hearing me. There is opposition around you. From today, I want to warn you so that you must never lose anything you have given by God. Don't trust anyone. So that the day you see what I saw in life, you'll be able to breathe continually. If you see what me and Mama saw, you'll be able to move forward. Because betrayers, opposers, fighters, hidden enemies are there. But I want to prophesy you this year that God will expose them. As a God will expose them. The reason why God expose your enemy so that you'll be able to move forward. Their expectation will never match in your life. I see God raising someone here, and you are taking over what God wanted to take over. If you believe, shout hallelujah. If we read 2 Chronicles 2:1, we found the Bible say Solomon was strengthened from the Lord. Can you see that verse there? Let's read that verse there. Can you read in your language?
Chronicles
2:1.
Second.
2 Chronicles 2:1.
Salomo he are ke agela leina la morena ngwako le gona e are ke aga ngwako wa moshate a hlaola banna ba dikiti tse mashumi a shupao ya ba go rwala dikago le ba dikiti tse mashumi a seswai ya ba go bita maswika dithabeng le ba hlapetse ba bona le dikiti tse tharo le magolo a selelago.
Listen to this. For God to call Solomon,
so ore modimo a bitse Solomon,
to be a person that will build his house,
ore abe motho ya tatang a agangwa ko wa gae,
it was not easy.
Na ise bonolo.
Sometimes you people, you don't know that building is not easy.
A letse boru a ga ke bothata.
If you build a bigger thing,
a wa ga ntwe kholoi,
the foundation must be very strong.
Motho o tsontjo ba otile ka nnete.
Solomon was given an assignment of building a very big thing. So he was supposed to have a strong foundation, strong knowledge that it won't be easy. Even if God will send people from far to come and support, he need to know what he's supposed to do. Remember when David wanted to do that, God said no. It's not your assignment. The assignment is from your son to your son
Solomon.
And the Bible says he was strengthened and he brought people to do that. Everybody could hear him. He was an old man. He was a young man. Think about when you are strengthened to do things. And when you look at your age, you feel you are not fit for that. There are some people who are here. They need to know that Adonijah is still around. when Solomon was doing that, Adonijah was there. He was given an assignment also that he must never leave the place. If you leave, you will die. And the Bible says he was strengthening this young man to build the house. Where was Adonijah? Where was the people who knew buildings before? Where were other people who tried to do that before? But because this one was the assignment from God, this man, you could not fail. Today you must know why you are here. Your strength must not be expired if God has called you for something. And I'm here with the mission of God to tell you that what God wants to do with you will never light up until people see it. They will see the plan of God upon your life if you believe, shout hallelujah. That's all, my friends. Even if you oppose the plan of God upon my life, you won't be able to stop me. I will carry on with what God wants me to do. I see some people receiving strength today to do something. There is something that God wants you to do. Don't turn back or look aside, because God has ordered you to do it, to carry it out, and your purpose is to fulfill it. If you believe, shout hallelujah. I'm called to preach. I won't stop preaching. I'm called to talk. I won't stop talking. I don't know if you are hearing me. Listen to this. Your assignment has been lowered a little bit. Some people hit you where you trusted. They try to break you where you trusted. So that whatever you will do, you won't do it in fullness. But I'm here to tell you, there will be a to see what God can do about your life. I'm here as a preacher, and I'm preaching to you that those enemies, they are about to see those enemies, those opposition, they are about to see that God has planted a big assignment upon your life. And how are you? Those who are coming to inspect you, because there are some people who come close to you to check. Do you think all of you are here because some of you are inspectors? You become spectators because you cannot partake on what God is bringing. As you are inspecting, I see God bringing the partakers to take what God is giving them. I'm here as a preacher, and I'm preaching to you your assignment. I see the strength that God is giving you, the strength to do things that will make your opposers to wonder. They will pull you down, but you will rise again. They will pull you back, but you will run again. I see you running. I see you partaking. I see you going somewhere. I'm receiving strength for my God. My plans are about to come to pass, and I'm born to succeed. I'm born to live a better life. The whole life and the weakling life is not my portion. I'm here as a preacher, and I'm preaching to you. You are facing what you're facing. But I'm here to tell you that this year is a year that people will know that your assignment is about to be accomplished. I'm receiving strength. Sit down.
Zorani Fasi.
I was saying, I don't want to preach today. I am tired of traveling the night, driving, preaching,
drive again.
And I began to hear about this message.
That,
remember, as I'm giving you strength, I'm giving my people strength. I have strength. Can I tell you this? I have strength. I won't be tired until God shows up. There's a strength in you. You need to exploit it and found it. Don't look at the people around you. Don't look at the people around you. They are there to make you weak. As they are busy around you, be busy with the what God has assigned you. As they are talking around you, be busy with what God has called you for. I feel strength. Are you feeling strength? I feel strength. Listen to this. Many of you today, you are like boxers. And you call yourself champion, but you never fought. I want to tell you something. When a boxer entered the ring, he showed the opposition. You do like this. He began to do like this. You know what he's doing? He's dancing for his victory before he fights. And that, you know, affects the opposers because they are looking at the distance. You know, the opposers do things to affect you and they want to hear what you are saying. This is the time you rise up, you dance your dance before something happens. You are not defeated yet. I don't know if you're hearing me. Because that's how your confidence will rise up again. And that confidence will speak for you. I prophesy someone. You're about to talk the language of champions. I say you're about to talk the language of champions. I see you with a testimony. I see you laughing. If you believe, shout out.
Hallelujah.
Look at this verse. I want us to go to Daniel 10. From verse 15.
Uto verse 15.
Daniel 10.
Verse 15.
You see the strength of the Lord, what it does. Can you read verse 15?
Gobane nna molata wa gago nka gona jwang go bolela le wena mongaka o mokaka nna jwale ke kwa ke sena maatla ke ka ke šitwa le go boša moya. 18. Ke mo gape e mongwe yo anke o ke motho a nago a nkgwatha a mpha maatla.
Stop there. You know, today you need a touch that will give you strength.
Fela o kgwathiwa ore o be le maatla.
You see a touch that will make the voice of God clear for you. It happens when Daniel, after he read the scriptures, he was troubled. And he said, I know I've got upstairs, but I'm in a foreign land. And then what is it that will happen? I want to know the future. He was with others They were praying on the other side of the river. And when they were there, there appears a man. And this man, you could see, he was like of sons of God. Because I was telling one time that, and then some people were offended that, let's get out of the angels who are bringing feathers. And any visitation from God is for message. The moment when God visits, is with the message of breakthrough. Can I tell you this? The moment, you know, there was appearance from heaven, and there were people there from heaven. Daniel fell by his face. Other people fall down. When they were down there, you know, he could feel that he was no longer having strength. In other words, whatever that was come there was so big for him to contain. Because he wanted revelation of what will happen. Because already this man, he built an upstairs in a foreign land. He had a desire to build that household. But there was life there in the land of confusion. But where he came from, there was nothing. The Bible says it was desolate. I don't know if you are hearing me.
Amen.
And the Bible shows that the prayer brought those people. When he was down, he heard the words, and he ended up saying, sorry, I can't hear again. I can't contain what I'm hearing here. He was touched to hear clear. Listen to this. We need to know our future. But we need to know it clear. I don't know if you're hearing me. Listen, if we don't have strength, we could still hear, but we won't hear it clear. There's the hand of the living God here that will touch you. God will open your future so that you won't be tired where you are. One of the reasons why we are tired where we are is because we don't know what will happen in the future. This makes us to think and think and rethink again. There are some people here that God has opened doors for them. I don't know if you're hearing me. They will see the future. They won't mind about what they are facing now. I don't know if you're hearing me. Because they know where God is taking them. I don't care about what I'm facing. I can see the future. I'm hearing God clear. Can I tell you this? If God can reveal to you the future, you know what will happen to you? You will never complain again. Even your decision, you revisit it. There are some decisions you have taken. You will revisit them. I want to tell you something that, can I tell you? I was telling this, we were speaking with prophets. And I've been saying this. There's nothing that will move me. Already I'm there. Already I'm there where God wanted me to be. If we talk about money, I have seen money. If you are searching for money, I have already seen money. I have already seen pain. I have already seen success. I don't know if you are hearing me. You know, there are some things that when people do, they feel like they are shaking us. They just feel like, oh, if this church falls, we are finished. Out of this church, I've already seen money. Whether this church is there or not, this church is no longer moving me. There's only one person who moves me, is Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
There are some people who have seen future. They've seen future. Nobody can do anything about
it.
You won't worry about what you are facing. You will laugh at what you are facing. I don't know if you are hearing me. Shake
someone
say, my friend, if you can see what God is bringing, you won't worry about what you are facing. If you know you're going to breach, what do you worry about poverty? What do you have to pray about poverty to change any situation? Because you have seen what is coming. I want to prophesy some people who are listening to me. I want to prophesy you. And this is your prophecy. And don't forget this prophecy until it comes to pass. Check this year and next year before
June.
If you won't lead in your family, check. I say check. From now on, even before
June,
if you are not on top of the whole family, check. I'm giving you my word. I say I'm giving you my word. I say listen to this. God is giving you strength. Crush everything around you. Stop complaining. Begin to rejoice. Because you know what God is about to do in your life. I don't know if you're hearing me. Did you hear that prophecy? That prophecy is not declaration. Giving you months, you are about to overtake everyone. Those who think you're a failure, God will really show them out. He will show them. I don't know if you are hearing me. Check somebody and say, hey, my God is about to show you. I'm sure you are hearing me nicely. So if you know, listen. You know when I say this church does not move me, I'm saying
what?
I'm sure since you came here, you never heard me talking a mic talk about anybody. You know, when you are a king, you don't need to talk about, you are a king, you don't need to talk about anybody. But everybody must talk about the king. There's a king. I don't know if you're hearing me. So, you know, people who talk about it's because they are under the ruling of the king. So they end up talking about the king. I'm ruling here. I'm ruling. I say I'm ruling here. I'm telling you now. I'm ruling. Even if you don't love me, you will hear
about Makalanisa.
So now it's your turn. I say it is your turn. Shake someone say, hey, can you stand up and tell three people? It's your turn to rule. It is your turn. To dominate, to be the first, to be on top. Glory be to Jesus. Can you lift up your hands? Ask God to give you strength for your assignment. He will do that now. Pray. I'm called. Give me strength of my assignment. I'm facing tough times. Give me strength. In Jesus' name. Listen to this. Where you are strong is where Satan wants to attack. I'll take you back to what Satan knows. Satan knows he knows nothing.
Satan
knows unless you inform him. That's why Satan always travels.
That's why Satan odula aliko tseleng.
Satan always travels.
Odula letseleng.
To find what is happening.
If you
remember what God said, where were you? He said,
I went up and down, but
I'm
going to
complain. I want to attack Job.
But
I can't get a space. And when I try, I find you are the one who
protects.
Satan knows nothing unless we inform him.
Satan has a solo cantaure.
That's why it's good to pray in tongues.
That is why I
That's why it's good to pray in tongues, so that he must not hear. Even Jesus, most of the time, Jesus, if you read about Jesus, you'll find that during the day, it's only one prayer he prayed. And Satan also heard it, even people here.
Satan,
when people hear, they say, I'll share. He loved Lazarus.
I'll share.
But most of the time, he never prayed. He just said, rise up and walk.
Be healed.
In the night, he went to pray. Because he didn't want Satan or anybody to hear. Satan knows nothing unless he's informed. All information which are from Satan are there to attack you. I don't know if you hear me. So you better close your ears. Because he's checking where you are weak. Even some people, when you are standing with them, they listen to what you are praying for. When you are praying, oh God, you are crying, God, do the 1, 2, 3. They attack you through that. They speak against you through that. You are on another house. Receive wherever you are.
Amen.
Can you ask God to give you strength? Prayer. Ask God to give you strength. I'm seeing people wearing strange things today. This church is not Charis. This church is Giani and Venda. Zulu. Awesome God, how great thou art. You are God, mighty are your miracles. We stand in awe of your holy name. Lord, we bow and worship you. Awesome God, how great thou art. You stay.